Sunday, and Big East play brings us to Civic Arena in Pittsburgh tonight. Our matchup, the Pitt Panthers host the Hoyas of Georgetown. And hi, everybody. I'm Brad Dessler. Welcome to Pittsburgh, an important midseason matchup between these two teams tonight. Georgetown ends a three-game road swing. They're in need of a victory. If they can win, they'll make it a two-way tie for the number two spot in the Big East standings. If Pittsburgh can win tonight, they'll move into the number two spot all by themselves behind UConn, and they're off to a great start this year. They're best in six seasons, in fact. A lot of talent on both sides, and for the long and short of it, we go to my partner, Bill Rafter.
Brad, tonight a classic battle of the big guys down on the block and the little guys outside running the show. For the big men, Othella Harrington, with the great step moves and the ability to step under people and a friendly release. Also, the shot-blocking ability to ignite the run. On the other end, Eric Mobley with strong finishes and blocking shots to ignite the break for Pitt. For a team to be successful, the little guys have to provide the punch. And for Georgetown, it's Joey Brown in the open floor, dishing and finding his partner. And Pitt, Jerry McCullough, whether it's in half court or the open floor, finds his teammate. Tonight, the big guys and the little men on Big Monday.
It's finally here. ESPN's Best of SportsCenter 1993 home video. All the events, all the highlights, the very best from all the experts, including your host, Robin Roberts. Relive 1993 for only $14.95. Phone 800-717-ESPN. That's 800-717-ESPN. Or send your check to Best of SportsCenter, P.O. Box 2284, South Burlington, Vermont 05407. Shipping and handling $3.95.
Today's office doesn't always come with four walls, so no matter where your employees do business, AT&T has a way to help. Call now for the AT&T Corporate Calling Card. We can customize a plan from over 70 features like flexible billing by location, individual or account code, fraud protection, discounts up to 40%, and worldwide access. The AT&T Corporate Calling Card. Find out how customized a calling card can be.
We're under budget, we're ahead of schedule.
It's Big Monday. We'll move to the Civic Arena in Pittsburgh in just a moment. Georgetown's won three in a row in the Big East. Pitt has won three of their last four. Welcome, everyone, to Big Monday. John Saunders along with Clark Kellogg. And today is the type of matchup that you like when the big guys start to bang each other.
Well, you talk about Othella Harrington and Eric Mobley, two of the best and biggest in the Big East. But I think this game probably will be decided in the backcourt. Jerry McCullough, the key for Pittsburgh. Joey Brown, the key for Georgetown, I think.
Yeah, important game because Georgetown can move into a tie for second place. Pitt can get sole possession. Game number two of the triple header. On Big Monday, number 24, Missouri. They were out of the top 25 for a week. They are back. They've won eight straight in the conference. Nebraska, they've won eight straight at home. Crazy eights at 9:30 Eastern time. We step aside for SportsCenter. Then Big Monday brought to you by Bud Light. UCSB against UNLV. That comes your way at midnight Eastern time. At halftime, Clark and I will be back to break down the first half and other games, as well as take a look back at the resurgence of the new number one, UCLA. Big Monday and Othella Harrington rolls along. When we return, Georgetown and Pitt.
George Strait.
Mom, tell the truth. Is everything all right?
Is this where we reverse roles?
Are you serious? I mean, you won't have to sell the house or anything, will you?
Well, why would I do that?
Mom.
Look, when you were away at school, Dad met with Greg Hall down at Payne Weber.
Oh, that was 10 years ago.
They set up this annuity just in case anything happened.
So you have enough?
More than enough every month.
Don't the Payne Weber guy know back then what Daddy wanted for you?
He asked.
You've waited for a car with Buick's reputation for safety. It seems you've waited for a century. Buick Century. with standard driver airbag, anti-lock brakes, power locks and windows, and more. All for $14,995. So don't wait any longer. See your Buick dealer today. This is the value of the century.
This man just woke up in a Residence Inn hotel room. What are his options? He can A, make a cup of fresh coffee in the kitchen. B, walk all the way over to the living room area and start a fire in the fireplace. Or C, shoot some hoops. Okay, let's see what he does. D, none of the above. Residence Inn by Marriott, the next best thing to home.
ESPN's exclusive coverage of NCAA basketball is brought to you by Bud Light. If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light. And by Buick and your local Buick dealers. Remember Buick, the new symbol for quality in America.
We get set for Big Monday from Civic Arena in Pittsburgh. And time to meet our Buick starting lineups. First for the visiting Hoyas of Georgetown. Arguably the most improved player maybe in the Big East, Don Reed, number two rebounder on the team, with Churchwell, Harrington, Jacques, who had a great game a week ago, and Joey Brown. For John Thompson, who didn't have such a great game over the weekend, only spent half of it on the court before he was tossed out in a loss to DePaul. For the Pitt Panthers, Chris Gant suffered a broken ring finger on his right hand earlier in the year. He is back to 100% now and playing like it, with Antigua, Mobley, Sharif, and McCullough. For Paul Evans in his eighth year, the head man at Pittsburgh, and the third best among active coaches. And as you saw, John Thompson number one in that category. Jody Sylvester is one of our officials tonight. There's Jody. Donnie Gray joins him. And the reason we talk about just those two is because we have only two to start the game tonight. John Clockerty. There's Donnie Gray. John Clockerty, who was the guy who tossed John Thompson out of the game over the weekend, had some travel problems. We expect him to show up probably about the first TV timeout.
You think he's being smart or travel problems?
I don't know. He ran into the SS Thompson over the weekend, so he'll be here apparently. Pitt Panthers 5-2 in the conference, Georgetown 4-2, and we're underway. Didn't take long for Othello Harrington.
He can run the floor. Nice look by Churchwell, and the Hoyas line up Miniman.
And Tigler, the team captain. And a lob underneath for Mobley. Got good position. And now has to try to get it out of there.
Well, he worked himself out of it, didn't he? Go up strong. Something will happen.
And Joey Brown will push it for the Hoyas.
Big concern, both guards. If they push the ball and penetrate, there's problems for the defense.
That's a strong move. A block by Mobley and a shot by Reed.
He's great at that, isn't he? Sees things, recognizes. Ulrich usually starts breaks for Pitt.
Joey Brown, jumper off the dribble.
Well, you know they're going to bounce back. John making sure at their workout yesterday and this morning, I'm sure that there was a little enthusiasm in their game.
They had some horrendous field goal shooting in that loss Saturday. And Tigwatt's side got the roll for three.
And acknowledges us as though we're the official score. I told him he had the tape on the other hand the last game I saw him.
Yeah, right. So much for the hurt finger, right? Here's a turnover. And Gant all by himself. Hit in front.
Almost took Jody with him. Sylvester a little trouble getting out of the way. But open floor opportunities, very important to both teams. Don't be surprised if you see a little 2-3 zone standstill action here. Neither club known at times for the shooting, Brad.
The entry pass, Reed wanted to try the hook shot. They just handed it off to Gant. And now it's Sharif the other way. And he missed the layup.
Pretty good hustle back defensively, but you got to finish that one.
Wasted opportunity. Sharif still has that look on his face.
A little box work for Othello, I think. He'll end up down low often here. He's got a nice little look from the jumper foul line or using the bounce to open it up a little. He's a tough kid on the block, and Mobley might foul.
He gets unbelievable height on his shots. He's starting off with a 7-foot body and then the long arms, and that thing's almost headed down to the hoop. but he still finds a rainbow in there, and he's got four. Georgetown with a one-point lead.
Little hands as Jack, we take a look at Othello as my partner Brad leaves Honolulu, comes to Pittsburgh just to warm up a little bit.
That's right.
But activity without the ball. Usually it's a screen away. And this time, just a little motion in their continuity up to the foul. You see Mobley not using that foot speed. And the knockdown by Othello. Little trap. They like to do this foul line down on occasion. And a 1-3-1 will come out a little higher.
And Tigua almost walked with it. Gave up an open jumper and walked with it, did Cherie.
How do you think you'd handle it if you were an official and John sort of stalked after it? Would I have to protect him?
I tell you what, I would throw you in the way. Somebody'd have to get in the way.
He took three down with him.
He did. It was like tag team wrestling on the way.
The same little play, continuity, passing. Look at that high low, and you mentioned Reed. Good luck, but that's a tough entry.
Foul underneath.
Years ago in Europe, particular era, they would not permit this directly from the top to the bottom, but with open middles and guys able to elevate so quickly, and nice looking pass by the big guy.
There is the big guy, Coach Thompson. Here's Don Reed, his numbers on the season, leading the team on the field, and his first point of the night. He has quadrupled his scoring from last year. That's why we say he's one of the most improved players really in the conference.
And that shot at John. And P.J. Colosimo was telling me he felt that Lou Conoseca and John Thompson were the best guys in the league, losing and saying the right thing. And if you recall after the DePaul game, he was very apologetic right. to Joey Meyer for taking away or detracting from their fine performance. It's a little show of style. The man looking to hedge.
And a blocking foul down low.
Now, Jody coming out with the call. You know, my old AD with two officials, the third check would not be whacked up.
I mean, you think these guys are splitting the check tonight?
I don't know. They may have a little agreement. But knowing Clockerty, he will be here and demand full entitlement.
What's up? Fouls on Churchwell out of the deep.
The zone, and there's the trap. They don't get over quick enough, and he has been playing well amid. Just a little push to free himself, huh?
Push underneath by Mobley. He picks up his first foul. Our shot clocks are down so far as we start this game, so we'll try to...
I think it was Mario Lemieux that...
slap shot at one of those babies.
This is his building.
Mobley on top, trying to stay with Harrington, and they feed it to Reed again, that little half hook.
And over the top, I believe. I don't know if they give it to Gant or Reed. Jody... checking it out.
Mm-hmm. He's going to be on Reed, his first.
How did you work this into your itinerary, by the way?
Busy man, but you know, flights everywhere all the time.
I guess you had that block out. Nice cross-court pass.
Had it blocked by Harrington. That's a great block. And Joey Brown the other way with a dish to Harrington. Oh, that shows you how he can run the court.
Is that pretty? And it also shows you when you don't convert, how you're at a disadvantage.
Othello 3-for-3. 5-point Georgetown lead.
Orlando didn't go strong to the goal, did he?
Nope.
A little weak left hand.
Nice ball move at that time, and McCullough nails the three.
And they don't get back now. Joey should be able to penetrate. A little mistake here. McCullough ended up on Jock, and Joey could have taken advantage, but didn't.
15-20 to go first half. Georgetown by two. Churchwell misses, and Mobley clears it. Pitt with a chance to tie. McCullough again with Jock on him. Leaves it for Mobley.
Great catch, Brad.
Foul before the shot. That was a nice grab. Foul will go on Reed. That'll be his second. And Georgetown will go to its bench. In fact, both teams will go to the bench with 15 to go in the first half.
You've waited for a Buick. You've waited for Buick quality at a low sticker price. You've waited for a car with Buick's reputation for safety. It seems you've waited for a century. Buick Century. With standard driver airbag, anti-lock brakes, power locks and windows, and more. All for $14,995. So don't wait any longer. See your Buick dealer today. This is the value of the century.
Delta Faucet has over 1,000 different styles of faucets to choose from.
Wait, just a sec.
So there's a Delta faucet that's right for everyone's needs.
Oh, okay, I'll get the food, you get the water.
Delta, the way water is brought to life.
And don't forget to turn it off.
Pardon me, but where are you going with all that Bud Light?
The Lee family reunion.
Then I'm here for the Lee family reunion.
You're a member of the Lee family?
Yes, I am.
Right this way.
你是李中的老大.
Sure.
If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
你真有点像他.
The great big man over the years at Georgetown and what they did through their first 47 games. You see Ewing's numbers. Dikembe Mutombo is actually a late bloomer. Alonzo Mourning even better than Patrick. The best of the bunch, though, Othella Harrington, numbers-wise, 15.5, 8.4 rebounds with plays like this, Rap.
If you don't go strong, he's going to get a piece of it. Ignites the break. Joey Brown, wonderful in the open floor. The strong little completion. Not a smash or jam, but nicely done by Othella. Got a step to the elbow.
There's the open man, Sharif, up high off the glass, didn't get quite enough on it.
Good looking cut as Spencer shows himself. This is a talented guy. We saw him last year, not playing as much this year, Brad.
He said an injury problem really has made that the reason so far. He's in there now with Harrington, so two big guys. This is VQ outside. And Yaya Ja coming
you.
In, trying to get the rebound. He picks up the foul instead. He played well last week.
He did. I'm glad you said it first. Gets me out of the gate. Number 44 with the foul. Give a little Kevin Lockery on the play-by-play. We're not sure of the name. But he did. He blocked shots and rebounded. But Spencer gave Reed a chance to show himself as Orlando tees it up deep.
Way out. Spencer all alone for the rebound. And here comes George Butler, the leading scorer for Georgetown, who's coming off the bench tonight.
And a guy that John Thompson has given the green light to. Anything he wants to do, go do it.
And he's taken it. At least he did in that game we did a week ago.
He isn't any traffic violations.
Here's a steal by Antigua. He's going to try to work through traffic. 3-on-2 Pitt. Sharif had it stuck by Ja. And McCullough, wise move to back out.
Aren't they quick recovery, though, Georgetown? You might get one. You're not going to get two. The lolly you.
Yes! That's the shot they were looking for. Tied at 10.
That baseline hide, when you've got his size, is very effective, and McCullough looks alert.
That got the attention of the Panthers fans. Harrington trying to feed it low to Spencer.
Both point guards, as we noted earlier, the little men running the show, and a little look left, and this is why a lot of scouts are here. He can run the floor, elevate quickly, and finish. Got to get a little dance step in his game. Maybe he ought to talk to you.
I don't think I'm the guy.
A few offensive maneuvers would help. Eric Mobley.
10-10. Butler, you can tell, looking for a shot. Got up in the air and turned it over. McCullough. Antigua. The finish. He got hacked by Ja underneath. This guy is... He doesn't lack for any dance steps.
No. Orlando or Ja?
Orlando.
Orlando does play with some enthusiasm, some youthful vigor. And here he went lefty earlier, but not quite as strong as that particular time. And there's a little personality in that guy. He enjoys life.
He sure does. He's still smiling through the teeth guards. And, that's the reason he's been named the captain of this team, because of his emotion on the court, off the court. Gets the attention of his teammates.
See the sleeve there, Brad? The right shoulder.
Rolls up the right sleeve.
A John Travolta look. Now, the reason he does that,
is that his first year a way to say hello to the folks back at home?
You know, how about the second year? Is that the teeth guard?
Well, he didn't get that far. That's a graduate situation.
Looking for his fifth point and having it. Orlando with five, and the lead is Pittsburgh by two. Churchwell, Spencer, Reed, Meekew, and Brown on the floor, and Meekew gives it up. Two turnovers in a row for Georgetown. Pitt pushes it. Sharif, charging foul.
Ooh, my goodness.
We've got more of this kind of action coming up. We'll move it on to the Big 8 next at 9:30. It'll be 24th-ranked Missouri against the Cornhuskers in Nebraska. And then at midnight tonight, it'll be Reggie Manuel. He stepped up as a leading scorer for the Rebels as they take on UC Santa Barbara. Two more games tonight on Big Monday here on ESPN.
Maybe they do need three officials.
I think they might.
Yeah. They got the walk on the baseline, but coming into your living room, huh? McCullough has a choice. They compliment both lanes and... the stepping in looked a little better for Georgetown there than it did live.
Last three trips down, Georgetown turnovers with a total of six. And Tigwolf nails it for three.
Against Seton Hall, he struggled with that outside shot, then sprained the ankle. And it gives them a lift. Now, both clubs have that problem of going dry from deep, so they need somebody to ring the bell. Butler would help Georgetown.
Pittsburgh's run the bell with a 10-0 run and a block by Mobley, who sends it into press row.
What a presence. Oh, I think I would have hollered if I were John on that one.
Uh-huh.
Over the cylinder, but he can get up. He's got to soften the rejection.
Reed out, Harrington in. 15-10 Pittsburgh with 12 minutes exactly remaining first half. Nice job defensively by Pitt.
Got to split those defense. Nice drive, huh?
Brown outside. His jumper's an air ball, and it didn't hit anything, and the shot clock goes off. Another Georgetown turnover. Four straight, and they trail by five.
For years, I never even thought about it. Guess I just didn't want to face things.
Yeah, I've been there.
But now, my parents... they need real help. It's gonna be tight. We'll just have to manage somehow.
I got this guy at Payne Weber. He put me in a mutual fund for my parents. Same time he set up my kid's college fund.
That long ago? I didn't know about your parents back then.
He asked.
Something wild is happening to men's grooming. Now the Gillette series of high-performance personal care products comes in an invigorating new scent. Wild Rain, the newest fragrance of the Gillette series.
You've waited for a Buick. You've waited for Buick quality at a low sticker price. You've waited for a car with Buick's reputation for safety. It seems you've waited for a century. Buick Century. With standard driver airbag, anti-lock brakes, power locks and windows, and more. All for $14,995. So don't wait any longer. See your Buick dealer today. This is the value of the century.
The little men, Jerry McCullough and Joey Brown. 3 points and two assists for McCullough as he nailed a three. Joey Brown with one field goal so far, and they have both been running the show. But the show for Georgetown has been a turnover situation the last four trips down court, not even getting a decent shot. A 10-0 Pittsburgh run has them in front, 15-10. Now we'll see some full court pressure from the Hoyas.
That's what Georgetown has to do, make it a little feistier type of game. Be aggressive, take some gambles, challenge shots. And a man-to-man, they like to go inside. Nice job by Spencer.
Kent didn't come to that ball quite enough. Spencer almost with a steal. Pitt still with its starting lineup out there. McCullough, Gant, Sharif, Mobley, and Antigua. And now he's trapped. Better hurry. Lobs underneath. That time, Georgetown forces a turnover.
Very alert by Othello.
Churchwell, smooth move to the baseline. Joey Brown didn't know he wanted it. Churchwell gets it back, and he finishes with a reverse layup.
Brad, I thought he shook it up strong the first time instead of kicking it out. Nice little double team on McCullough last trip. Much more active defensively by the Hoyas.
Cuts the Pitt lead to three. Joey Brown might come up with another one if Jock can get to it. He leaves it for Brown. Spencer finally gets the handle on it. McCullough with a nice job defensively, or that would have been an easy two.
Pretty good recovery. Go inside, let the big guy work.
Harrington pushes it back. Churchwell glides the lane and didn't get the roll. Mobley with the board. Eric is alone under there, 6'11", about 250.
And he's trimmed down, Brad.
Yeah, he has.
Spent that summer, played a lot with Charles Smith. I think they should go in here, let him do something. See if Othello will foul. Not a bad looking jumper.
That was a good looking shot, just didn't go. And a foul on the rebound. It's going to be on Gant. And for Chris, his second. Midway point, first half. Brad Nessler, Bill Raftery from Pittsburgh. A battle for second place in the Big East going on between the Hoyas and the Panthers. Georgetown's led by as many as five, so has Pittsburgh right now 15-12.
Little staggered double here, Brad, in the lock low.
Harrington fades. Again, nice weak side rebound. Again, he ran into it. Couple of trees inside, and one of those trees got a branch on it.
A pretty good cut by Gant. I thought that may have been a play on. Pittsburgh coping beautifully.
Churchwell gets his second foul. So you think that was at least a nickel dimer?
I would give it that small change category, but it was one of those deals where let the guy take the shot. Willie Cauley on the sideline, Brad, who'll be coming in shortly. A starter most of the year and a big physical specimen. Shot selection at time is the concern of the coaches. I believe he's coming in for Gant.
Gant at the line. Short arms, a free throw off the front, and Jock pushes it up to Joey Brown, who's got to go to the floor to keep the dribble.
Back to man-to-man.
Brown, nice job to get his man up, and he drains the jumper. Looking to draw the foul, and now he's got a chance for a three-point play.
A little show of strength as Joey Brown can dribble in traffic and take the hit, a little NBA style.
And the foul on McCullough. Jerry picks up his first foul, and Joey Brown has got a chance to tie this game up for the second time tonight. Joey, the only Georgetown player to go over 1,000 points, 500 assists, 400 rebounds, and 200 steals. That's pretty much all-around play. And he caps off that jumper with the free throw, three-point play, and a tie game at 15.
Busy career.
Sharif, nice move inside.
David Darlando, you think? A nice little step in by McCullough. And good presence, Brad, to bring it back out. This is a little play they've been effective all year. Nice look.
Great pass underneath, and now a chance for a three-point play for Cauley.
Well, Jerry is alert tonight. Turns the corner, has good vision, and then delivers.
Othello Harrington picks up the foul. Spencer will sit, and Reed comes back in for Georgetown.
At the line to try to complete the three-point play.
They officially now give that last basket down there to Cauley. Both Cauley and Antigua over there. Antigua's going to keep it alive here, though, with a rebound. A tough one in traffic.
And Pitt playing with a lot of spirit. Occasionally, they will have some problems against Seton Hall. It didn't look like they were in it. Nice little turnaround.
Boy, he's got that move down, but he just can't buy it from that spot. Missed a couple there. Joey Brown pushes it, trying to loft it in for Harrington, and it comes free to Butler.
He blocks passes, Mobley. A little bit of everything. Pretty good balance in identifying their guy by Pitt.
Harrington, great look inside to Reed. Back. 19-17, 8 minutes left first half.
Back to that 2-3. Boy, Othello is multifaceted, isn't he?
Reed keeps on trying until he gets it right. He's missed twice from that spot. He buries a three, and it's a five-point Pitt lead.
Oh, what a screen.
Great screen. Brown takes advantage of it.
Oh, great understanding. Why not use that body when you're running by?
You'll feel that shoulder tomorrow. Run it into that screen. 22-19. Pittsburgh at home with a lead. And a kickball, a fresh 35-second shot clock, and a timeout with 7.5 minutes to go. First half, Pitt leading by three.
I talked about getting down the floor, getting the bump, and why not use the big fella, Othello, and he goes right to the tin, and Brown on the money.
Tomorrow as Illinois faces Wisconsin live on ESPN.
A Blackhawk is a big swooping bird. A Red Wing is a little chirping bird. Tough to size this one up. The Chicago Blackhawks versus the Detroit Red Wings. Tomorrow at 7:30, NHL on ESPN2.
The stars of Big Monday. And we've got a couple here tonight. As you see, Harrington and Mobley and Brown and McCullough, and there's the big guys underneath. Mobley so far, 2 points, but he's blocked shots, he's blocked passes. Othello Harrington leads Georgetown inside with 6, but it's Joey Brown outside, who has 7 points to lead the Hoyas. They trail Pittsburgh 22-19.
In the 2-3 zone, Jock is in the back, he's gonna have to rebound against Mobley.
Good luck.
Yeah, he's also going to have to play him down there.
Sharif open again. Now he's got it working. Back-to-back threes for Ahmed Sharif. 6-point Pittsburgh lead. We haven't seen the offense from John Jock yet tonight that we saw a week ago.
He didn't have it the other day against the ball either.
He didn't.
He did against Seton Hall.
Harrington jumps into some traffic.
Good
and walks with it.
He tried the jump stop, but did it haphazardly.
He jumped, I think is what it was.
Ira Davis, hop step, and jump.
Under 7 in the first half.
A double down for Sharif. So this is where he can't break his guy, though. He's dribbled himself into position.
He'll try the right side.
I apologize, Sir Eric. Little jump hook.
Mobley with 4. The lead's ballooned to 8 points.
Got to get Joey Brown back in, right?
Yep.
John Thompson doesn't waste any time. They are a different club with him out.
Reed in low. Had it blocked by Antigua. Comes out to Sharif.
Reed and Cawley having a tag team. Oh, my goodness, what a... I don't know if they give it... Othello put the forearm up. They could give it to either guy, and as the case generally is, the second guy gets it.
That was a pretty good collision in there.
As you go across, you'll see a little thrust into the chest area. And Willie gets down with an insult and injury.
A nice block if you're playing in the Super Bowl. Not so good if you're out here on the basketball court. 27-19. Georgetown, though, turns it over again.
Got to be careful on those post entries against the 2-3.
McCullough, the flying runner. And the foul on Joey Brown.
I'm sure you're getting a lot of calls about the Super Bowl down there in your home area.
Relatives I don't even know.
Big John. Trying to get some action for his big guys. That 2-3 zone, if you don't make shots, they keep backing it in a little bit, jamming the passing lanes. Somebody has to step up and make some outside jumpers.
Jerry McCullough, 4 tonight, at 23 off the bench in the win over Villanova on Saturday.
They were very impressed with the Cats, too. Cats played them well, played Syracuse well, beat Georgetown.
You just looked at the two guys who make it tough on each other tonight, though, McCullough and Brown. Jerry got both free throws. 10-point Pittsburgh lead. Georgetown in need of some points and no more turnovers.
The foul line is open if you pop in and then reverse the ball, but again, you got to make the 15-18 footer.
Churchwell, baseline, nailed it. So that ends a dry spell for the Hoyas.
Now, Roberts, a guy that can light it up. Good baseline stroker. Got to get him involved a little bit. Maybe he's on fire. Go with the hot hand. They can't dictate every night who it's going to be.
Harrington had early points, and he has cooled considerably. Way outside the three by Cauley.
Don't take my outside game away, Willie.
That's his fourth three of the year, and he puts his team up 11.
30% from three.
Reed walked with it. 11 Georgetown turnovers.
They do have some beef under there, don't they? With Cauley and Mobley, Brad?
Cauley and Mobley are a double load, that's for sure.
That'll deter a few people. Blitz, the dribbler.
Entry pass comes off the knee of Harrington. McCullough had a notion, and now he'll penetrate and try it in close, and he got it.
Great sleight of hand as he moves to the left.
Might want to think about a timeout here if you're Georgetown, and John Thompson thinks the same. Pitt with 17 points off Georgetown turnovers, and they trail by 13.
You're gonna miss the bus. Don't do it. You'll miss the bus.
McDonald's doesn't just make breakfast fresh, hot, and delicious. At McDonald's, we make breakfast fast.
Which mom is what you get? What I tell you, she missed the bus.
At McDonald's today.
You've waited for a Buick. You've waited for Buick quality at a low sticker price. You've waited for a car with Buick's reputation for safety. It seems you've waited for a century. Buick Century. With standard driver airbag, anti-lock brakes, power locks and windows, and more. All for $14,995. So don't wait any longer. See your Buick dealer today. This is the value of the century.
Faucet has over 1,000 different styles of faucets to choose from.
Wait, just a sec.
So there's a Delta faucet that's right for everyone's needs.
Oh, okay, I'll get the food, you get the water.
Delta, the way water is brought to life.
And don't forget to turn it off.
Pittsburgh with 4:20 left first half with a big lead. And our big men, little men comparison, Mobley and Harrington, they're battling all night in there, Rap.
Well, down on the block, he bounces himself into position, and this is going to help the other guy. Othello stays at home. A little array on the release, and here's your little guy. drags the D with him and goes to the left hand for a half a kiss on that particular one. That was an upper lip.
That was a peck. That was not a full kiss.
You can't go far without the little guys.
Georgetown has scoring from only four players tonight and not much from any of them, as most of it's come from Brown and Harrington.
A little bit of a gut check right now for Georgetown. I think after a tough loss against DePaul, got to get into it, score, and get their pressure ready.
Harrington wheels around Mobley.
I don't know. He's going to call a walk here. He kept that pivot foot. It looks bad because your advanced foot keeps hopping. But after the timeout, get it in to some strength.
John Thompson only clapped about that. Didn't argue the call at all. Mobley on the entry. He's going to try that same shot. This one won't go.
Oh, Othello holding on to his shirt. And McCullough comes up with it. Oh.
McCullough the steal and the foul before the shot.
You are seeing summer league basketball at times here. This is only two officials. Guys whacking away, pulling shirts. Eric Mobley almost had to play skins. This, he gets the jump hook, and Othello now makes sure he doesn't go too far. Let it stretch material. It could be embarrassing.
Jerry McCullough back to the free throw line.
Jerry's picked up two of these on inbounds passes where Georgetown has not been alert.
It's about as lazy a free throw as you'll ever see. For his eighth point of the night. Scored 12 in each game last year as these two teams split. Pittsburgh winning here 51-48. And Georgetown winning on their home floor 80-66. Here it's become all Pittsburgh as they've gone on quite a run here with a 15-point lead. This is a 17-4 run.
Guess which game I had.
You had the 51-48 game. You know, I had that low-scoring thing follow me to Gainesville for Kentucky and Florida last week.
I watched
you. I had Seton Hall, Georgetown.
I watched you. Although it can be exciting.
That's right. It was a good game.
They get after one another.
Steal by McCullough.
Look at Orlando.
Jerry leaves it for Sharif. And Churchwell the rebound.
Thought he had Orlando earlier. Ended up the extra bounce took him out of the play.
Church. Too strong. McCullough the rebound. It's going to be a three-on-one. If Jerry pushes it fast enough, he does. Sharif with a finish.
Amid the stars. Nice little drag left by McCullough. They've got some fire. And maybe for a purpose, huh? This is good run for Paul Evans as well.
Is it ever? 19-4 run. It is 38-21.
Unless you knock him down, you can see a lot of zone. It takes away the entry passes also for Othello.
Churchwell. Sweet move. Churchwell, he got that baseline shot down, and that ends a string of over 3 minutes before Georgetown was able to score any points. Don't forget, coming up tonight, SportsCenter from Atlanta. Update on Troy Aikman's condition, the team arrivals, a new Falcon coach, old buddy of mine, June Jones, will take over the reins there. We've got something like, I don't know how many people, the paper said today ESPN's got more people covering the Super Bowl than any other network, and they're all down there, and they all want to sleep in my basement, but they will be coming up with SportsCenter from Atlanta tonight.
And get a receipt.
Exactly. I've got a stack of them waiting there.
Should be a great week, though.
Under 2 minutes.
A direct entry or a reverse to the top. There they go. Good save.
Pitt can afford to be very patient. We don't have any idea how much time's on the shot clock. We don't have shot clocks tonight operating. I think Jerry McCullough was thinking about that when he put that one up. Goes around, weaves through traffic, trying to leave it out there for John. He finally does come up with a handle.
Double, yeah. Gotta explain that rule, huh?
15 turnovers.
Even Joey on the open floor there, not a good look as he hit his teammate on the head. Somewhat disorganized on the break. They just don't have a good flow going.
Delta Fawcett halftime reports just a minute 20 seconds away. UCLA for the first time in a decade, the number one team in the country. Clark will have his proper props, scores from other games, and a lot more. Stick around for our Delta Fawcett halftime report. It's a minute 15 seconds from now. That's probably how long Eric Mobley and Othella Harrington will be able to sit to give it a little extra rest.
Would you say Gant might be a proper prop someday?
He could be.
You know, the contributing type of guy. Mobley a prime timer. Little brush, nice step up defensively.
Pauling kicks it out and take one. This one doesn't go off for him. And the rebounds to Joey Brown.
Too many guys. Jaime Peterson involved there with Cauley.
Game clock in the corner of your screen till halftime with a 38-23, 15-point Pittsburgh lead.
And Pitt will have the hammer, so you want to get a real good one that's tippable if you're the Hoyas.
Morgan, a cross-court pass. Churchwell doesn't get it from that baseline. McCullough with a rebound. Plenty of time for the Panthers to take one shot.
Nice heady play here. Pull the plug. Milk.
Paul Evans trying to get Jerome McCullough's attention. I think he knows what the situation is. He's going to take it himself. Didn't get the shot. Second chance. No.
Feisty little guy.
He has had quite a half. So has Mobley. And so has the Pitt Panthers. The end of the first half of play. They lead 38-23. Right now, let's join John Saunders and Clark Kellogg with a Delta Fawcett halftime report. Guys.
All right, guys. Thanks a lot. Georgetown Hoyas continue to struggle as they did on Saturday. Welcome to the Delta Fawcett halftime report. I'm joined here by Clark Kellogg. And, Clark, you may have to take over here. My voice is getting ready to give up.
Don't put that kind of heat on me, John.
I know you can handle it. We'll have scores and highlights and take a look at UCLA's rise to number one when we return.
ESPN's exclusive coverage of NCAA basketball is brought to you by Menin Speed Stick Deodorant and Speed Stick Antiperspirant, the number one for movers and shakers.
You've waited for a Buick. You've waited for Buick quality at a low sticker price. You've waited for a car with Buick's reputation for safety. It seems you've waited for a century. Buick Century, with standard driver airbag, anti-lock brakes, power locks and windows, and more. All for $14,995. So don't wait any longer. See your Buick dealer today. This is the value of the century.
Explore your world.
The faces of discovery are the faces of the world. When you set your sights on the fascination of real-world entertainment, find yourself here. The Discovery Channel. Explore your world.
It's Domino's crunchy thin crust pizza.
It's thin.
Crispy.
Crunchy.
And check this.
Free pizza!
Order a large thin crust pizza with two toppings.
And get any medium one-topping pizza.
Free!
Something for nothing when you call Domino's.
For this guy, any deodorant will do. But these guys need Speed Stick. Antiperspirant that gives 110%. And now Speed Stick deodorant has a powerful new formula to fight odor. Speed Stick. For movers and shakers, the number one, the only one.
Welcome back to Big Monday and the Delta Fawcett halftime report. Georgetown and Pitt. Pitt with the big lead at halftime. Let's check some other scores. North Carolina facing Butler. Remember, Butler beat Indiana this year. Tar Heels with a big lead, though, 44-25. Brian Reese and Jerry Stackhouse with 9 points apiece. Appalachian State against Clemson, just a four-point game at halftime. Sharon Wright has 11 in the first half. Xavier and Dayton, second meeting in the last 2 weeks. Xavier's won five straight in this meeting. 3 minutes to go in the first half. They lead it 38-24. Loyola of Chicago facing the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. It has been a tough year. We'll get the news on Joe Bugle in just a moment. John McLeod is still the coach of Notre Dame. Monty Williams having trouble, misses the layup. Then he misses from outside. And then Marlon Burton gets a chance on this one as they just get too many knocks on the board, sticks it back. Loyola by 12 at halftime. Notre Dame has 19 points. There's 16:37 to go in the game. They shot just 19% in the first half of this one. So nobody on the Irish will be getting the proper props this week, at least not as far as that game is concerned. Who does?
Melvin Booker, a guy we're going to see actually in the next game, is a true point guard that can score. You see more of these scoring point guards in college and professional basketball than you've seen in the past. Here's a guy, leads the team in minutes, scoring, steals, and assists. He can do it inside and outside. A pretty physical point guard. Here you see him showing you his range from downtown. And he also has the ability to get inside and not only penetrate, but finish plays inside. Here's a guy that's had an outstanding career, having a great senior season. Our other proper prop moves out to the SEC. We'll see Wesley Person tomorrow night. He's playing the big guard position, has tremendous range. Look, he's 3 feet behind the three-point arc. People know about his brother Chuck, who's gone on to play in the NBA, but Wesley Person deserves some recognition in his own right.
Yes, but can he talk like his brother?
Can he talk like his brother? Not quite. He's putting up numbers, though. He's averaging 26 points a game, leading the SEC in scoring.
All right, as you mentioned, we'll see him later this week. News from the National Football League now. Joe Bugle has been fired as the head coach of the Phoenix Cardinals. A season of 7-9 this year, just 20-44 in his 4 years as the head coach, this despite winning his last three games. We'll continue with more of the Delta Fawcett Halftime Report on Big Monday in a moment.
This Halftime Report is presented by the Delta Fawcett Company. Delta, the way water is brought to life.
A certain look. It's the little things that are worth the most. Which is why every Delta faucet gives you more than you'd ever expect for the money. Giving you the money for those things you can't even put a value on. Delta, the way water is brought to life.
When David and Lisa Edmondson needed life insurance, they came to see me. I'm Kent Spearman, their State Farm agent. I help the Edmondsons put together a life insurance plan that works for them and their budget. And I stay in touch as their needs grow and change because that plan has to work for their children, Rachel and Travis, too. If you want life insurance that works for you, get an agent who works for you. Get yourself a State Farm agent.
State Farm sells life insurance.
Sure. Unsure. Sure. Unsure. Sure. Unsure. When dryness really counts, be sure to be dry. Sure Solid has the most effective wetness-fighting ingredient you can buy. For dryness no one can beat. So you're either sure or unsure. Sure. Unsure. Be sure to be dry.
Hurry, girls, before Daddy gets up.
Ooh, ready.
Now, no more of these are Daddy's corn pops.
Oh, look, Daddy's bowl is too full.
The problem with a cereal that tastes like popcorn, only sweeter, is that it disappears like popcorn, only faster.
Mommy, that's Daddy's.
We share.
Hi, girls.
Happy birthday.
Thanks, guys.
Now, let's all go make him breakfast.
Kellogg's corn pops. It's hard to stop when it's pops.
As someone once said, there's a new sheriff in town, and it's UCLA, number one on this year's AP Top 25 this week. Back to the Delta Fawcett Halftime Report. As we just showed you, UCLA is the new number one team. Wins this past week over Arizona and Arizona State, getting them to the top spot. Has people thinking back of the wonders of Wooden. Mark Schwartz has a look at how they got to number one.
The critics said he couldn't recruit the top local talent. Then Jim Harrick signed Charles O'Bannon, now one of the nation's best true freshmen. They blasted his teams for playing soft defense, for having no true center. 7-foot junior George Zedek was recently named Pac-10 Player of the Week, and the Bruins are forcing more turnovers than any other team in the Pac-10. And finally, Jim Harrick is getting some respect.
He is the Rodney Dangerfield of coaching. He just doesn't get enough credit
that he deserves when you look at the whole picture of his career.
The turning point for Harrick, last March, when he received a three-year contract extension. In a matter of weeks, he signed Charles O'Bannon.
Certainly the contract helped, and now we got some, I think people feel, well, there's continuity and consistency, you're gonna be there a long time, as I told you when we started, it's kind of over the hump.
I think he's much more relaxed now. He doesn't have everyone on his back about winning, about being a coach next year. And I think that he knows his job secure, and he's just proud of the team that he's built.
What a difference a year makes. Prior to last season, Harrick couldn't land anyone during the early signing period, and speculation about his job security raged throughout the season, not only in the media, but in living rooms across America.
Did any of the other coaches or recruiters tell you, hey, Jim Harrick's not going to be there, go with us?
Yes. Yes, they did. They tried that approach, but I call that negative recruiting.
Nothing negative about this fall's recruiting efforts. Harrick delivered four blue chippers. Meanwhile, unlike some of his previous UCLA teams, this one hits the glass, shares the ball, and beats lesser foes convincingly. No more seven-point squeakers against Cal Northridge. After getting pounded by the Bruins, LSU coach Dale Brown called this the most talented UCLA team since John Wooden left 1975.
Do you think you underachieved in the past?
That's a good question. I think we did, in a sense that we didn't win as many games as we should have. I think this year will definitely be a different story. We play hard every game in all phases of the game.
It's been 19 years since UCLA won the last of its unprecedented 10 national titles. Harrick is now selling his program to recruits born after Wooden's retirement.
UCLA didn't mean that much to me. I knew about John Wooden, the championships.
You know, I'm from Portland, Oregon originally, and I didn't know anything about UCLA basketball. I didn't know anything about their national championships and so forth.
The words UCLA still have a little bit of magic in college basketball.
Still.
I believe that, yes.
And so does next year's highly touted recruiting class, considered among the best in the nation. So Harrick appears to have a future in Westwood after all. But there's no time like the present to recapture the past. In Westwood, I'm Mark Schwartz, ESPN.
Following Bear Bryant, that had to be tough. John Wooden had to be just as tough to follow him.
Oh, no question about it. But Jim Harrick has done a nice job, and the administration of UCLA to be commended for staying with him. Now a solid foundation has been built, and it looks like it's going to be solid for a while. And that team they have now is very talented. They've got a great point guard in Edney, and the O'Bannon brothers are dominant at the small forward and big forward spot. They can do it all. They've got good balance. They're a team that's certainly going to have a chance to win it all.
Yeah, and the point you make is true of all the coaches to follow John Wooden. Looks like Jim Harrick's the first who's going to get that type of support. We'll continue with more Big Monday in just a moment. Here's a look at some more scores. Southwest Louisiana trailing Western Kentucky by 10. Deion Jackson, Chris Robinson, 10 points apiece for Western Kentucky.
Saturday night at Nassau Coliseum.
Is this extreme or what?
Game number two on Big Monday from the Big Eight. It is up at 9:30 Eastern time. Missouri ranked number 24 facing Nebraska. Then following SportsCenter at midnight Eastern time to the Big West, UC Santa Barbara against UNLV. Back with more in a moment.
Question, if your cold pill's so good, how come your symptoms keep coming back? Because your pill doesn't work 24 hours. Introducing Efodac 24, the first cold tablet so effective, just one works 24 hours.
Look, most cold pills drop off after 6 hours, the rest after 12. So your symptoms keep coming back. But just one Efodac gives consistent relief for 24 hours, so your symptoms don't come back. New 24-hour Efodac keeps cold symptoms from coming back.
What you're supposed to watch.
The bay leaf debate. Spice or garnish?
What you wanna watch. The Action Pack. 52 weeks of original action adventures from Hollywood's best action filmmakers. Action never seen in theaters, not available on video, and coming to your TV. Once a week, every week, on The Action Pack. Not what you're supposed to watch. What you really wanna watch. Check your local listings.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
Charles, you are a role model.
I'm out of here. Bye-bye.
Hey, Mike, I got my own shoe.
My own initials on it.
Yeah, well, I have my own shoes with my own name on it.
Well, can you do this in your shoe, Mr. I Don't Play Anymore?
Yeah, but I don't have to. I'm retired.
I'm not. My shoes got this strap.
Laces.
Black.
White.
White's wimpy. And you can't keep it clean.
Size 13.
16.
Ooh. Nike Air.
Mine's got more.
I went ball first.
Did not.
Did too.
The closest. The safest. The smoothest. Gillette Sensor. The best shave in the world.
One, two, one, two, three, four.
Give me a break. Give me a break.
Play me off this bad chicken.
Give me a break. Give me a break.
Play me off the bass.
ESPN's exclusive coverage of NCAA basketball is brought to you by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately?
Halftime in Pittsburgh and the hometown Panthers with a 15-point lead over the Georgetown Hoyas. Welcome back to Civic Arena, everybody. Brad Nessler and Bill Raftery. Raft, you can't go 7.5 minutes and only get a couple of baskets, as Georgetown did, and expect to be in the game. Big men, little men, though. Let's take a look at the comparison.
Mobley playing beautifully. This time he bounces to a jump hook. Saw a turnaround jumper earlier, but the big fella, Thella, getting him up and down. And this, I thought, was an intimidating factor in the play of Pitt.
There's the numbers. Harrington has the edge with the points, rebounds, and blocks goes Mobley way. How about the little guys? Jerry McCullough's been sensational.
All McCullough so far finding his two guard. Sharif, who sends it in. And then the old patented alley-oop. And Eric can tear it down.
Jerry's almost on a triple-double pace with his 9 points, 5 assists, 4 steals. And he's got the better of it for the little man. But we still have a half to go. Keep in mind, we saw Georgetown a week ago be down big to Seton Hall. They came storming out of the locker room with a 12-0 run, and they're going to need that tonight to get back in this game. Our third official, John Clockerty, has made it here. There's John. He's only getting a half check, we just told him. And we told him not to mess the game up now that he's here.
Now, I would have to fight with the priest in the old days to get him a full check. I know that. Let's hope he contributes here, huh?
Pitt has not lost this year when leading at halftime, 6-0.
Let Mobley touch it, I think. See if he can do some damage down there.
And he got pushed down there. Halftime statistics, 48 even on the field goals, but the 3-point shooting, the big edge for Pitt, 6 of 7 out there. The turnover story, 15 for Georgetown, and Pittsburgh turned it into 19 points. Fouls on Harrington down low. That's Othello's second.
And they go to power right away. Nice ball movement.
The Tigua finds a way to get open. Couldn't get the shot. Joey Brown will push it. Lobs underneath. Churchwell almost ran out of real estate. That was Reed, not Churchwell.
Little 2-3 look. Let's see if they can make it. It's sort of the Pitt outlook. Got to get through the gaps with some dribbles.
Joey Brown trying to leave it inside. It's stolen away. And Sharif comes up with a loose ball on the run. Got it.
Was that incredible? His use of the body and also the great speed. Robert Churchwell can get after you.
So the lead balloons to 17.
That's the area that's open and then find some people.
Joey Brown, three-pointer, a little too strong. Mobley, what a wicked outlet pass that was. Antigua will pull up and nail it.
Oh, and they got a foul on Brown, too, I think. Trying to check out, got a little overzealous.
That's as good outlet pass as we've seen this year.
You like that, huh?
That was a beauty.
Whip on it. Orlando liked it as well.
Joey Brown picks up his third personal.
It gives a four-point possibility here as well, or five.
Largest lead of the night, the Pitt Panthers by 19.
I think they're going to have to double this guy. He's doing a bad job.
By 21. Wow.
He carves out Lillery, doesn't he?
So much for Georgetown coming out with a strong beginning to the second half. It's been Pittsburgh's.
Well, Othello was open. You got to get him involved when you can, too. Nice cut by Churchwell.
Churchwell with eight.
To get Mobley, nice look to Gamp, but you've got to get Mobley the ball. He's on fire. Forget about that now, not necessary.
Oh, we're going to mix it up a little bit underneath. Broken up as Gant got tangled up down low. Let's take another look.
Reed and Gamp, we might have had to have Charlie Steiner in to call this one, but at the end, and that usually happens, and Othello versus the big guy, and it wasn't Reed.
So the possession arrow, as there was no foul called after that, goes in the favor of the Hoyas.
And Jody just talking to Cox, saying you wanted to show up for this, huh? This is just starting to heat up.
That's right. Just in time for a fight, 2 minutes into the game. 2 minutes into the second half. 44-25, Pittsburgh. Hoyas have yet to hit a three-pointer.
I thought that was goaltending, huh?
Pittsburgh ball.
Ooh, I thought that was on the way down, Brad Nessler. Churchwell, as noted, has done the best job of all the Hoya guys, finding a little area, whether it's a cut or the dribble. I don't know, huh?
Close one. He finally left it for Gant. I don't think he knew he was going to get that nice of an assist out of it. Can't connect. Pittsburgh by 21.
They just have to be intelligent, and I still push the ball, take advantage on situations. I think a little bang under the other. Gant, who's known to pick rather strong, but take advantage of Mobley.
Gant's going to pick up his third. Joey Brown hit the deck. Nobody in foul trouble at this time, really. Joey Brown's got three. Gant's got three.
You're a trooper hanging in. You've been under the weather with your travel.
Hey, I don't sound half as bad as John Saunders.
Yeah, John sounds like he's been coaching a little bit.
No kidding.
I got a little shot.
On McCullough.
And Paul Evans was up. John Clockerty almost had the P inserted. Ready for the tee. It's intriguing as Paul has not heard one way or another on his job how well this team has played. And this school might be forced, whether that's the word to use, because they haven't shown him their love or concern, to tender him a contract.
They're off to their best start in the Big East in 6 years. If they win tonight, and they're certainly well on their way, they'll have a 6-2 mark. And the foul's going to be on Sharif.
That diagonal pass is so tempting. And Joey DeSantis in front of Paul Evans here. This one's up for grabs and amid. Just a little bit late with the tag.
Second foul on Sharif. The year that They had the 6-2 start was the 87-88 season, and they won the regular season Big East title that year, 12-4.
Pretty look. The fella showing another dimension in this game. Nice dump down.
Churchwell leads Georgetown with 10.
Fella fighting down on that box, and Mobley trying to go box to box.
Joey Brown trying to pick up the intensity on McCullough a little bit, knocks it away.
See, their game is getting after you, Brad. They just haven't lit it up on a consistent basis to extend the floor, change the pressure points, change the D, give people a lot of looks. That was the concern coming in here for Pitt. Can we handle it?
Third straight road game for Georgetown, and sometimes that can take a little bit out of you, but they have not looked sharp tonight at all. Almost 4 minutes into the second half, 46-27. Seven on the shot clock. Sharif outside. Mobley keeps it alive. McCullough went up with it, had it knocked away, and came back down with it. And he was hacked out here on top, trying to get the pass down low.
Great step through, huh? He was dead. Ball fake to the corner, and look baseline.
Foul on Butler. That'll be his first, and with 15 minutes, 59 seconds to go, it's going to be an uphill climb for the Hoyas. They trail 46-27.
Pitt's next home game is Saturday.
I went out to buy a car and came home with a truck. Everybody saw my new Ford Ranger and said, are we in luck? Now I've been driving nonstop because my girl likes to shop and my mom wants a fridge from way over the bridge. And my boss just bought a condo. Better start hauling pronto. My best friend says it's cool. Let's go cruising like we did in school. Don't get me wrong. Ford Ranger's the truck I'm gonna keep. I just wish I could get some sleep.
It's Domino's crunchy thin crust pizza.
It's thin.
Crispy. Crunchy.
And check this.
Free pizza!
Order a large thin crust pizza with two toppings.
And get any medium one topping pizza.
Free!
Something for nothing when you call Domino's.
For this guy, any deodorant will do. But these guys need Speed Stick. Antiperspirant that gives 110%. And now Speed Stick deodorant has a powerful new formula to fight odor. Speed Stick. For movers and shakers, the number one. The only one.
Great setup, huh? 120-inch screen, Dolby surround sounds, Corinthian leather seats, and enough snacks to last the rest of the season. What else could you possibly want?
Another Diet Pepsi?
I just ran out.
Remember to fill your fridge with Diet Pepsi or the party's over.
I had everything. I had the hot dogs, I had the pretzels.
Great setup, huh?
Well, once again, looks like the Big Eight is up for grabs. Missouri and Nebraska right in the thick of it. And the number 24 Tigers and the Cornhuskers meet following our game at 9:30. And then following SportsCenter, we'll take you to the left coast. UC Santa Barbara and UNLV will square off at midnight tonight. Two more games yet to come on Big Monday right here on ESPN.
Norm Storch got his club playing well.
Sure does. We've got just under 16 minutes to play in this one. Brad Nestor, Bill Raftery with you from Civic Arena in Pittsburgh, where it's been all Panthers since about the midway point of the first half. They had a couple of runs in the first half, one of 10-0, and then a 19-4 run at the end of the first 20 minutes, and they have not looked back.
Now, Brad, I always tell you about the feisty, aggressive style of the Hoyas, and it hasn't evidenced itself.
Hasn't shown up tonight.
They got to get after it. And pretty good defensive set now. They got some shot clocks down to seven.
McCullough, three. Rebound pulled off by Reed. They need defensive stops, and they need to make some offense work on the other end. This is a guy that can do it for them. Harrington rolled out.
Well, he got free easily. Pitt's got to tighten it up. Nice look.
Sharif, he can really glide when he starts working on the open floor. Had it knocked away that time by Joey Brown.
Chris Mullen loves to strip from the rear. Joey Brown showing you that time. But Othello, if he can get free and be active, that could help them. We've got to get something going.
Do they ever.
John, in the predictment I was daily. Come on, guys. Reach back a little.
And the foul. Don Reed picks up his third. Fourth team foul on the Hoyas. McCullough. He move. He gets picked, so he's in by a play.
It's the ref to help. Now Mobley hasn't touched it much. See, they forget him. He's not a guy that's going to light it up for 25, 30 points on hooks and turnaround jumpers, but when he's going, ride him a little.
Yep, and he's had some sweet moves in this game so far.
And they got a perfect spot, and he clears out. Now they're going to run their little set.
Mobley and Harrington down low. And Tig was going to work the baseline. Goes.
Ooh, he's all pumped up.
A dozen for Orlando and Tigua. Back to a 21-point lead.
Kick opposite.
Harrington faded too much. Reed will keep it alive.
Good job by Mobley.
Nice spin and the kick out to Morgan for three, and he nailed it.
Morgan only getting 4 points a game. John sort of just trying for guys to step up.
Tigua short on that one. Joey Brown almost walked with it. He pulled down the rebound. Great bounce pass. They can't finish. Two misses inside. And now Sharif spins the other way. His last two have paid off for him.
Whole lot of shaking going on. Nobody knocking it down. What a look and catch by Joey Brown and Robert Churchwell.
Joey Brown nails a two-pointer. That's it to 48-32.
Now they can get back in. All of a sudden, a little more stress on the shots for Pitt.
They pick up the intensity on the defensive end a little bit now after scoring, and now they clear another rebound. Churchwell ahead to Morgan. But Harrington's in front of him. He dishes the other way instead, and it pays off.
They are on a run right now. The big fella, he's got a little more spunk going. The guy's a little more spirited, and Pitt's struggling on the offensive end.
Chance for a three-point play for Don Reed coming up. But that'll have to wait. We have a timeout with 13:08 remaining in the ball game, and Georgetown trying to edge back into it.
Yeah, golf. Football. Golf.
No. Football.
Let's watch both.
Miller Lite presents Full Contact Golf.
Yeah!
We're still on the first hole, Bob, and this is Davis teeing it up. Here's the drive. Yes, bar! Brought to you by Miller Lite. If you can combine great taste and less filling, you can combine anything. Oh, he's got daylight going for the green. Here's the putt. There's the blitz. It's good!
Yeah! Tough hole.
Good beer. Great taste, less filling. Can your beer do this?
You don't think a car can change your attitude? Watch. Take this guy, give him a probe, lose the sweater, change the hair, voila. Or her. Give her an Escort GT, lose the glasses, makeover city, and bingo. Whoa, this guy needs a Ranger bad. Let's do that grunge thing, and off you go. A lot of work here. Definitely Mustang. Lose the pocket protector. Heck, lose the whole outfit. And throw that man a wave. Ford. Serious attitude adjustment.
Ben and Connie Studebaker look at things differently since they became parents. I'm Roger Kuhl. I'm their state farm agent. Having a family brought a lot of changes in their lives, so we thought it was a good idea to sit down and have a family insurance checkup. We started by adding to their life insurance protection. Then we went over all their family insurance to help make sure their coverage was up to date. After all, you never know what could happen.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Big Monday from Pittsburgh. Othella Harrington for Georgetown has not scored this half. Joey Brown trying to get his team back in it, though. And right now, Don Reed will try to cap a three-point play. If he hits it, it'll be an 8-0 Georgetown run, which is exactly what they need to try to have a chance in this game with 13:08 left.
Makes it also sets up the opportunity to press, and you see it right away. On the ball, double the inbounds, and then step up.
Interesting stat that the last three trips down, Georgetown scored, Raft. It's the first time since 4 minutes into the game that they've had baskets back-to-back-to-back, three trips down. That's amazing.
It is incredible. Turnover is really the problem. Boy, they open up the baseline here.
Sharif makes a nice adjustment, drew the foul from Churchwell.
There's a play. Georgetown usually rallies. The baseline dribble, the impact of their defense is essentially hustle and feistiness. And there, you saw a little bump. They didn't close down, didn't get the retreat and help that they generally do.
Third foul on Robert. And Amit Sharif, a 6'3 senior out of Chicago, to the free throw line. He's really stepped his game up. His career average, 5.3 coming into the season. And he's at 11.5 a game so far this year, and he has 11 for this game. Othella Harrington comes back in. Spencer will sit.
He's got one shot. Step in.
The tabs on him was he was a streaky shooter, Brad. As you know, you got to knock him down with some degree of consistency.
And he does to make it a 15-point margin again. Brown, Churchwell, Harrington with ball in hand. Don Reed and Max Morgan way outside. Five on the floor for the Hoyas. Harrington, top over Morgan, a little short with it. And now Sharif and McCullough will push it together.
Nice pry, though, huh? Didn't see it. Yank it back out. Wait for the big guy.
Smart move by Jerry McCullough.
Look at this shape up in the lane.
Mobley can't get it. Churchwell, another rebound. He's done a nice job on the glass, especially this half.
Been getting that entry pass to the post.
Well, great dish to Reed. Score it. Chance for a three-point play.
Robert on the money with that dribble drive. Almost like it's against the man-to-man, and Reed opens up. Nice catchable giveaway. The kiss. Attractive for the Hoyas.
And a nice double in that it causes Mobley to pick up his third foul. So a chance for a three-point play by Reed, and he will sit down, the big fella, for the Pitt Panthers. Don's got one three-point play this half. He'll try to tack another one on right here.
Pitt's struggling on the offensive end, too. And all of a sudden, door closed. Unable to find exactly what they would like. Now, without Mobley, they may run more of their sets. Mark Coleman doing some diagramming. You think guys know when they're out of the game? Think they really
I was going to say, can you really concentrate on the diagrams while you're over there trying to watch your teammates play? All alone, Sharif waits. Gets it back out to McCullough.
Let it go.
And nobody touches the rebound. Nice job boxing out by Harrington to let that ball go free to the baseline. Georgetown ball. They are trailing by 12. They can get it back to 10 or under if they score this trip. And with that, the fans come to life knowing that Pittsburgh's hit a little bit of a rut for the first time tonight.
First time I've seen them really attack the shooter at the other end, Brad. Really went after people.
Reed draws a double team. Churchwell, that's tough if that goes, but he got the foul out of it. Foul's going to be on Collin.
Well, this is what I was talking about. Attacking, playing relentlessly. Here, attack one. You think you got an open jumper, somebody else comes over. Good reaction, ends up an errant toss. And down on this end, Churchwell has found the gap. Driven, slipped the pass, that time able to get to the free throw line.
Reed and Churchwell have done most of the work offensively so far this half for the Hoyas. Harrington still held scoreless. 8 points tonight, season average out in that 10 category. That one comes out. Hoyas as a team shooting about 71% from the free throw line. Well, got the second. Makes it an 11-point game. And here comes the full-court pressure.
And they just didn't get the fourth guy in it. Didn't get that guy reading the passing lane. High pick and roll.
Morgan on McCullough now. That means Joey Brown's got to pick up Sharif.
Nice job inside.
Peterson. No good on the jumper. His first shot of the night. Joey Brown all the way himself off the glass.
What a job clearing out, too, by the big guys. They protected the dribbler.
9-point game, single digits for the first time in a long, long time.
Nice steal. Lamont Morgan made the goal that time, slipped in. That's their game. Get it down and dirty.
Pittsburgh lead was 21. Georgetown with a 14-2 push to get right back in the game. Brown, three.
Got it. Knocking at the door right now.
50-44.
He lost it himself.
The doors are coming off a little bit for the Panthers. Another turnover. Georgetown scores here. Paul Evans may be up with the timeout call in a hurry.
Not waiting for the TV timeout either. Jerry McCullough got into traffic but didn't find anybody.
Reed. Foul before the hook shot.
Now, you mentioned Harrington hasn't scored, hasn't had the field goal. He has made some great looks. John has found the spot on the foul line. He's been able to turn and deliver.
With Mobley on the bench with his third personal foul, Georgetown's put together a 7-0 run, so they've taken that intimidation factor out of the middle, and that certainly has helped the cause for the Hoyas.
A little scared eyes for Pitt, too. Don't you think he's starting to get a little nervous?
And now Harrington will rest. So one big guy out, the other one will go and sit. Don Reed, good-looking night.
Same thing.
But he missed the free throw. Mobley immediately makes his presence felt.
Well, you got him in using.
Another collision. Joey Brown is... spent about half the night on the floor. Pauly over Brown.
Well, is that confident? Dribbling against the little guy, who's terrific at stealing the ball.
52-44, Pitt by eight. 9:20 to go.
Nice move going man-to-man, too. Pitt, you know, get the adrenaline going, too. Get your guys involved.
Brown, off balance.
Gets out of control once in a while.
Picks up his fourth foul. And for the first time tonight, John Thompson shows some of that fire we saw Saturday. 4 personals on the guy that's running the show for Georgetown. That does not help the cause.
And it was McCullough who got in the way, too. Big goal by Corley. Wasn't really able to step up.
John Clockerty with the block there to help Jock get control of the ball. And with all the smoke clears, it'll still be the ball out of the baseline.
Pretty good defensive wizardry by McCullough as he got back, and a good piece of officiating. He got all ball. Georgetown gets back the basketball, but right here, McCullough, extraordinary, huh? Almost comes up with the pilfer.
4 steals in the first half for Jerry.
I know there's no pilfering in your neighborhood.
No.
A little in mine. In the old days, a whole lot.
Well, we have to slow things down here to towel off the court.
I mean, the little kids out there, they put a heck of an exhibition. Even you applauded at halftime.
They did. They had the dribbling act and the spin of the balls out there. There's about 60 of them on the court at halftime. Future stars in Pittsburgh, I guess.
All potential campers. That's where the coaches like.
That's right. I see that 120 for that kid. Churchwell had it blocked by Mobley.
Good strong move though, and Antigua saying slow it down. That's why coaches will play anything in a Nassau. They just think of it as another camper.
McCullough. He drew a foul.
From the rear. John Jock on the rear, and this is a show of headiness right now. As Jerry McCullough has done some things on the offensive end and the step in at the other end.
See some other scores from around college basketball and the NBA tonight. Here with 8:29 left, 52-44 Pittsburgh. Jerry McCullough has not scored this half until now. 5 for 5 from the line. They call him Ice, 5'11 junior out of New York. Joey Brown in foul trouble on the Georgetown bench. The two big guys still battling underneath.
And both clubs have that dilemma with either point guy out. They just don't have the leadership.
Back to double digits, Pittsburgh by 10.
Great target in there. Nice help out by Qualley.
Harrington had to try to knock it off one of the Pitt players. It didn't work. A turnover for Georgetown. Just got that pass in too low. Call a great pass inside. knocked away, last touch by Collin. Pittsburgh turnover. And right at the 8-minute mark, we have a timeout. Georgetown made their run, but now they're back down by 10.
You'll save.
Save money.
Money.
Great prices.
PC.
Super service.
Happy to return. You'll save.
Save money.
Money.
Great prices.
PC.
Super service.
Richard. We have many innovative programs to strengthen Long Island's businesses. After all, Long Island's future depends on the success of our business community. LILCO offers rate incentives and a variety of energy conservation programs. We also help companies make use of Long Island's highly skilled workforce. We're a one-stop service that works with government to help our businesses take advantage of tax incentives and cut through red tape. If you have a business on Long Island, call us. We want to help you succeed.
Charlie Ward leads the Florida State Seminoles charge against Georgia Tech. Mo better ball.
Hey.
Saturday on The Deuce.
Think about it.
In the next game, there'll be literally dozens of shots better than that.
And these are two teams that can prove it. Massachusetts and Cincinnati take the shot Thursday, live on ESPN.
Pittsburgh stretches it back to a 10-point lead. 8 minutes left in the ballgame, Raph.
Brad, we haven't said too much about the defensive pit, but you'll see Cawley come down here and double. And at the end of this particular play, if we can get this clear going, great hands I've been known for, you'll see the out top as we hold it, you'll see the anticipation by the point guard who didn't stay asleep. McCullough out and involved, and they end up going the other way with it. So a nice bit of help out because Reed is outside and not a shooter, permitting Cawley to go double.
And that turnover problem that really hampered Georgetown to the tune of 15 in the first half has stepped up here in the second half, but they don't need it. They need points with under 8 minutes to go. Harrington has not scored this half.
Oh!
That is a push by Mobley. I'll have to really call goaltending. They won't.
What a shame. I thought he did a nice job on that particular trip. Kept control, had poise. This is number four. There was a bump, but I think it was from the rear. And Willie Cawley.
John Thompson wanted a goaltending call. Did not get that, but did get the fourth personal foul against the Panthers pivot man.
And Jody with the whistle poised. And he has his own fans here, Jody. The only referee I know of. Jody's boys.
Jody's having some words with John Thompson. Harrington finally scores, first point this half, and only one rebound on the night. That is not the kind of night you expect from this sophomore.
And a big key is going man-to-man by Paul Evans. Got his club away from the zone, got them emotionally into the game.
Reed, strong rebound on the miss. Georgetown can get it back to 7 or 6 if they can hit a 3. Doc thought about a 3.
Now this has been their most effective, the high-low.
15 on the shot clock. Harrington will take a 17-footer and nail it.
Boy, does that drag Mobley out too? No wonder Reed's able to roam so easily.
7-point game. Sharif had to get a lot of air under that one. 14 for a mid.
Boy, he has found his game of late. A very confident stroke. Once again, Mobley dragged out. Shape up by Reed and Church while lingering on the baseline.
Harrington thought about taking that shot from the same spot and he caught too long.
Substituting into the lineup for Georgetown.
20th Georgetown turnover.
A little frustration there for John. Othello trying to pry. Probably should have reversed it and got it dumped down.
And those 20 turnovers of Georgetown's have turned into 23 Pittsburgh points. You do that over the course of the night, you're going to win.
20 is a big number.
Sure is. Stuffed by Harrington.
Great reaction.
Joey pushes it, the lob ahead. That's broken up by McCullough. Who else?
And Cawley gets down and bangs off of Othello. They have just not converted what the opportunity has shown. You got it in his hand. Good things happen. They take the legs out and slap away.
The offensive end for Pitt. Just over 6 minutes to play. And a 9-point lead. Cawley. He's not afraid to put it up. A little bit of three.
Pitt has balanced beautifully, though, Brad. And they've gotten back, identified, played a terrific defensive game.
Georgetown hasn't gotten any fast break points at all.
Maybe
not many.
Early. Not too many.
Trying to set something up to get the pass in low to Harrington. It's Churchwell on the spin. Harrington pulls down a strong rebound there. And Strowman.
And he stayed after. Churchwell's terrific without the ball. He gets free. Good look for him. Good luck at that.
Georgetown hanging around, trailing seven. McCullough just using some time out on top.
And they are just doubling up on that point guy.
Calling. Tipped by Antigua will go. The rebound, Harrington. And since I said he didn't have a rebound this half, I think he's got three.
Well, he heard you. Or somebody heard you. He does have to dominate for them to be good.
Round around a Harrington pick. So he'll do it himself.
Yeah, he'll get it going. It's 40 long minutes.
16 for Joey Brown. 5-point game. Will Mobley had a tough catch, a wobbly catch. And now Antigua loses the handle.
Trying to do a little too much. Should have given it back to McCullough.
Well, you and I were talking about a 21-point game a few minutes ago. Joey Brown got whacked on his way to the basket, and they do get the call. Got it right in the chops, I think, as he took it to the glass. That's on Mobley, and that's it, Bill. Now the game changes complexion.
It sure does. Becomes a forward guard kind of a game. That last penetration, Don Reed, an unsung guy, the way he clears bodies out. He's headed that path to the goal.
6 points, six boards, but that intimidation factor inside from the big guy will be gone. Remember, it was an 8-0 run when he sat earlier in foul trouble, and that's what got Georgetown back into it.
Paulie's going to have to become a physical performer now. He's usually the guy picking, and as you noticed, made a three, stepping in for jump shots at the foul line. Now he's got to go down on the blocks.
We showed you Joey Brown's halftime numbers. They trailed McCullough's, but it's been the Joey Brown show this half. He has 18 points. The lead is down to three.
And Thomas in the game, another one of those streaky type of shooters. Straight up man-to-man.
We're down to 4 minutes. Brad Nessler, Bill Raftery, and 13,000 from our close friends at the Civic Arena in Pittsburgh.
Nice anticipation in there. Lamont.
McCullough. Cawley, nice catch and a chance for a three-point play.
Well, the guards, the center of attention for both clubs. Electrifying in a sense, the way he penetrates and then hangs and finds people. And Cawley down where he should be.
Here's the foul coming up, too, from Reed.
These are the guys that this size used to kick your blanket when you were younger. Unfortunately for you.
Sand in the face.
He is a big individual.
Fourth personal now on Reed. Cawley with a chance to complete the three-point play. High off the back of the iron and down through. 3 minutes and 51 seconds to go, and Pitt in front by six.
Don't forget the Panthers next game.
Canada, the birthplace of ice. Molson Ice, ice brewed to be colder and bolder, yet smooth as ice. Molson Ice, from the land where ice was born. Now, to each man who shaves, there's an edge all his own. Only Edge Gel has eight custom formulas to fit every shaving need. From tough beards to sensitive skin, for a close, comfortable shave, get an edge of your own. Edge Gel, skincare for men. Ultimate closeness, ultimate comfort. That's the Edge. 3 decades in the making. And worth its weight. In gold. The all-new Ford Mustang. It is what it was, and more. It's Motor Trend Car of the Year. Canada, the birthplace of ice. Molson Ice. Ice brewed to be colder and bolder, yet smooth as ice. Molson Ice, from the land where ice was born.
Othella Harrington has picked up the pace when Georgetown desperately needs him. He has 11 points. Mobley's gone, having fouled out for the Pitt Panthers. And the little men, we told you it was Jerry McCullough's first half. It has become Joey Brown's second half, though, for the guards. There's Mobley out with 5 fouls.
You have been all over Othella, and he has stepped up beautifully.
He is stepping up. That's what I like to see. It's the way he's supposed to play every day.
You were just saying he didn't get many rebounds, but the offensive proficiency, negligible at best, has to step up right now.
I got to write that
for the Hoyas.
Offensive efficiency, negligible at best.
Proficiency.
Proficiency, excuse me. I knew I'd mess it up.
And they go to the right spot. Huh?
That's proficiency right there.
While the big guy's out, you had a great point. You're not inhibited when you're down there. You don't have to worry about Mobley.
Mobley out of the way. Pauly really the only guy that can save the day underneath now, beef-wise, for Pittsburgh.
As a coach, John's got to feel comfortable. He knows where to go on different trips right now.
Gant. A chance for a three-point play, and Joey Brown has fouled out too, and he is unhappy.
I guess Gant is helping him out the way he discarded. Once again, some nice interior passing. And John Thompson has a serious dilemma without Joey.
Sure does.
The cut here to the hole, and Joey so offered it up. Great step in. They do not give it to you too often under the tin, and you got to admire that little guy.
There's why John Thompson's got the dilemma. Joey Brown has put on a show in the second half. 18 points. He's been the spark, but he is gone now.
And who do you turn to? Well, John Jacques, a guy who in the past has played a little point. And they go to Butler, who has been quiet. George, a guy that can handle the basketball.
George hadn't scored.
No, penetrate.
Morgan had a three-pointer in this half. All the scoring other than that for Georgetown has been on Brown, Churchwell, Reed, and Harrington. So Butler, who came in as a leading scorer, 15-2 a game, back in there. Meanwhile, Chris Gant to the free throw line. 6'7", junior out of Houston, Texas.
Brad, they do run motion, so they should be able to just pass to the wing and cut through. Also, with Othello doing such a nice job the last trip, they've got to get him to the box and get him involved.
7-point game. Butler with McCullough on him.
Again, a lot shorter is King outside. Othello has to take him low.
Morgan now backing out. And we're down 10 on the shot clock. Harrington baseline. That's a sweet shot.
And you can't help but get the shot off. He's got 3 or 4 inches on Chris Gant.
Back to a 5-point difference with 2.5 to play.
Great intensity on Harrington's face right now. He knows it's up for grabs. Big stop.
Monday just getting started in the Big East. Don't forget Big 8. And then UC Santa Barbara and UNLV at midnight with Sports Center in between from Atlanta, side of the Super Bowl. McCullough. Rebound. Butler had it and lost it.
And nice control by Antigua, too. A reset. They're letting them bang a little bit under there.
Fresh 35 on the shot clock. You see the game clock under 2 minutes.
A little pop out.
Antigua. Good ball and a rebound. looks like pulling down with this shot is Churchwell. Still time for the Hoyas.
But rudderless when you think of it.
Yep.
You don't have that ingredient that ignites them, Joey Brown.
I'd get it to Harrington and worry about the 3 points later. Butler.
Tough shot.
Got his own rebound. He knew that was going to miss badly, and he knew where it was headed. Time on the side of the Panthers, though. John Thompson says, let's talk about this, guys. 1:14 left in the ball game. Georgetown trailing by five. They'll have the ball on offense when we come back.
With full confidence, I submit to you an affordable economic package.
Senator, this will cost only
$10.99.
$10.99. Man's an idiot.
I'll say it again.
Would somebody call security?
$10.99.
What could anyone possibly get for $10.99?
I'll give you my boy.
Bigfoot Pizza from Pizza Hut with that special crust delivered for only $10.99.
Hey, Dad, who's going to sponsor this bill?
Bigfoot Pizza, a legendary value.
99 years ago, we built our first Kelly Springfield tire. In that time, Americans invented TV. We fought in two world wars. We flew the first airplane and settled the West. We all had to start somewhere, and someone had to be first. Kelly Springfield, America's oldest tire company.
Pittsburgh with a lead by five with 1:14 left, but Othella Harrington's got Georgetown back in the game, Raph.
Well, he's smart, and you know that Mobley not there. He can bounce himself into position. Look at the elevation and knockdown ability, but it's what he does in a quiet fashion as we get some help and the step out. As Orlando thinks he's got an open shot, and all of a sudden a hurry, an intimidation, whatever you want to call it, and it's going the other way.
There's the lack of intimidation for Pittsburgh. That guy had it up until 4:17 remained in the game when he fouled out. And that's changed everything in the eyes of Othella Harrington in particular. He's got 9 points this half, 15 for the game. Joey Brown was the big spark this half, too, but he fouled out at 3:09 to go. So we talked about big guys, little guys. One big guy out, one little guy out.
Oh, almost a violation.
Churchwell off the inbounds. That would have been a miracle to go in. That was a very tough shot.
Big time rebound by Gant. And a quick giveaway.
Foul on Morgan. That'll send McCullough to the free throw line.
I'm sorry, Brad. Guys know how to use the clock, don't they? Stop it right away, give the foul. You mentioned earlier, I'm not so sure you need the three. You got plenty of time. Minute and four. You get the two, get yourself, maybe they'll make a mistake at the other end.
They had about 1:18 left when I said that, but they went outside twice. Now on the other end, Jerry McCullough has a chance to start to ice this game. That's his nickname, and he's perfect from the free throw line tonight. You see, 6 for 6. He's got 6 assists to go with his scoring tonight. He just keeps right on putting them in there.
His buddy from New York, rooting him on the Pines. A masterful job by Joey getting his team down. They showed a lot of emotion second half, and directly as a result of his play.
Got them both.
Defense, you want them to use clock. Offense, you got to get your quick hitters. Othello playing outside, I'd run him right to the box. The spin out for three.
Butler still hasn't scored tonight.
Oh, Gant has been magnificent in elevating as Churchwell goes from the rear.
Don't forget, we've got more action coming up in about 52 seconds. Number 24, Missouri, and the Cornhuskers of Nebraska follow our game. And then after SportsCenter, we go out UC Santa Barbara and UNLV tonight at midnight. Two more games yet to come on Big Monday on ESPN.
I'd say Gant wanted those last couple of rebounds.
Did he ever?
He does present himself in a big fashion.
Free throw comes off. They consider him by far their most improved player. He really hit the weights in the summer and again in the fall, and you can see that that has really helped him so far through half a season here.
He likes to play physical. He's a good screener. Use him out high generally for McCullough on their pick and roll.
And now time very much running out on the Hoyas. They trail 65-57.
Tough pass to catch. A lot of emotion by Pitt, though. And Paul Evans has to feel awfully good, and I think people supporting this program got to feel awfully good about him, or a lot better.
They have been excellent tonight. Butler, your leading scorer, doesn't score. That doesn't help the cause if you're a Georgetown fan. Butler didn't start the game tonight, and he didn't score. John Thompson's going to see back-to-back defeats.
Butler has a pretty good imagination for the game on the offensive end, too. They're going to need some excellent play by him. But if they stay in the game like they did the second half, they got a shot. They can't play that down and not aggressive type of first half.
Fine line, though, between imagination and reality sometimes. And George has not been real tonight, I don't think. Mm-hmm.
You can see the numbers not stroking it. Well, you come out of the gate strong. The race is not to the swiftest, my friend.
Sometimes it's a marathon, not a sprint. McCullough.
Very few wire-to-wires in my day.
McCullough hasn't missed from the free throw line. Pittsburgh 16, now 17 of 20 from the stripe. You do that, of course, a lot of turnovers, and you've got yourself a ball game. They're about ready to win. They're 11th of the year. And a foul called with 25 seconds left.
After foul committed by number 5, Jerry McCullough.
Well, you got to get some rest, but you got games to do.
We got miles to go before we sleep.
Well, they did it late without Mobley, and maybe part of it was Othello not getting enough looks in the latter stages.
He had 4 of his 6 points very early in the game, and then they just went away from him completely. And then he put on quite a show the second half, especially when Mobley was sitting. But not enough tonight for Georgetown.
Paul Evans wasn't feeling good today, and I spoke at Norm Law's assistant, and he said they got to limit their bad shots, and I think they did tonight.
Yeah, they did.
Plus some spirit. And not easy to be in his position, where you're not sure exactly how the school feels about you.
Last year, that win that Raft and I talked about, the game he did here, the 51-48 game, is the first time they'd ever beaten Georgetown in this building. And number 2 coming up in about 20 seconds.
Nice play by Sharif as he brings the ball out on the cross-court look.
Churchwell fouls out. Pitt will move up, and they'll be ahead of Syracuse. And as we said, to start the game tonight, second place, all to their lonesome, behind undefeated UConn. Syracuse will fall a half game back into third. Georgetown into a tie with Boston College at 4-3 in the number 4 spot. So that's what this game meant tonight. Churchwell has fouled out. Joey Brown also has been gone for quite some time.
Better looking Georgetown team, though, than they were Saturday in the second half. Now, forget the first half. So it bodes well for them and not too well for the opponents.
As we said, now Georgetown finally gets to go home.
Now you see these situations where a coach isn't sure and a club steps up. It's a nice, healthy situation. And it hurts recruiting when you're not sure. And other people, I think by innuendo, will mention the uncertainty of the situation. So it behooves for academic integrity that they let him know and the kids are recruiting quickly.
He's had 3 21 seasons, 6 postseason appearances. He's done a nice job getting this crew ready tonight. Harrington will cap off his night.
And Brad, they want graduation, and his is very high. I think it's in the 80s, the rate of kids who've gotten through. So put on a little bit of a tear in G-Town. The Hoyas have to get back to that hard, aggressive style of basketball that John Thompson's kids have been known for.
Pittsburgh on a roll. They have won 3 in a row. And they win it tonight at home by 8, 68-60. That's going to do it from Pittsburgh. For Bill Raftery and our entire ESPN crew, I'm Brad Nessler. Thanks for joining us. Now we send it back to the studio, John Saunders. John?
All right, guys, thanks a lot. Pittsburgh comes up with the win. They have sole possession of second place in the Big East here on Big Monday. And Clark, as you assess the second half, a bit of a run by Georgetown. They got Othella Harrington involved, but Pitt's lead was just too much.
Yeah, it really was. The turnovers early really hurt Georgetown, and they got themselves back into the game, but were unable to get over the hump, and Pittsburgh did a nice job keeping them at bay late in the game.
Pitt as a team, McCullough has been a bit of a mystery for them at times, but tonight looked terrific.
When he's good, he is outstanding. He can get in the lane, he can shoot the three, and he's an excellent passer. When he's under control, that team is really a tough team to play against.
Yeah, Othella Harrington, we mentioned, had a good second half. They got him involved. How did they do that?
Well, basically, Eric Mobley fouled out with about 4 minutes to go, and that gave Othella Harrington a chance to use his size advantage here over the smaller Chris Gant and then knock down the little turnaround jump shot. He didn't get enough touches early, but when you're turning the ball over, it's hard for anybody to get touches.
Yeah, 20 turnovers was the last count I saw. As a result, Pitt comes up with the victory. We'll continue with more Big Monday in just a moment as we move you on to the Big Eight. Number 24, Missouri, will face Nebraska. That one is coming up in just about 10 minutes' time. And then following SportsCenter on Big Monday, it's UC Santa Barbara against UNLV, that at midnight Eastern time. First, let's look at some scores. North Carolina all over Butler. Butler beat Indiana earlier this year. 104-64 is the final. They have a 10-game win streak in non-conference games. Eric Montross with 18 points. They won by 47 in this matchup last year. Appalachian State against Clemson, 66-56. Sharone Wright had 20 points and 13 rebounds. Florida Atlantic against Iowa State. This one with about 14:20 to go. Iowa State has the big lead, 58-25. Fred Hoyas.
The shot.
The kiss! Orlando.
Well, they got the kick out pass.
What kind of shot was that?
Well, we haven't seen one.
What was that?
The kiss.
First basket of the ball game for Antigua, who averages 11. That coming under 3 minutes left in the ball game.
And look at him. He's got a little life, too. And a nice discard as he gets back on. Artemis.
Karnisimus blocked. Griffin with the rebound. I believe they've got the foul as Griffin was going to score. You know, Karnisimus is known not to be able to create on his own. He apparently is trying to show folks he can do it.
Well, they're not pinching on him. He'll pick it up because he doesn't want to make a mistake. I'm impressed with Mobley sniffing out the basketball. He gets a piece of shots and distracts and distorts and makes them hurry.
Well, Mobley hasn't done it very much in the scoring column with only 6 points, but he's got 4 blocks and 7 rebounds. And Mobley certainly is working hard and saddled with 4 personal fouls, 2:28 left in the ball game, and Seton Hall in control right now.
And James Pitt's got to get the quick hitter. And Seton Hall defensively has to make them use some clock.
McCullough penetrating and is fouled.
That's quick.
Smallest man on the floor taking it into the land of the Giants.
The blow by with authority.
And he can slice nicely.
I've been looking for McCullough to assert his personality. And he's got 2:20 left. He's going to have to step it up. You said slice with a little spice. And everybody getting back and trying to identify. They can't see him. And you see the nice hold off by Mobley, and that is a nice release. The touch, just not effective for Pitt.
Here's a guy who logs an awful lot of minutes as well, the team leader in minutes played.
35, huh? Four rebounds besides, you mentioned earlier, those 8.6 assists. So a solid contributor. And that tells you what a job Caver has done on him.
Rarely changes expressions, McCullough. Very, very placid, even individual out there on the floor.
Changes expression at St. John's, though. He said all those friends, coaches.
Okay.
Yeah, family.
That will do it.
It's like a New York reunion when they go up there and a terrific win against a solid St. John's team. You don't win at Alumni Hall too often. Here's the press now. They got to get the trap and the rotation. Sharif didn't step up. Seton Hall carves it slowly in pieces.
Does a nice job of handling the press. Well executed.
Sections.
That's good coaching.
Chuck Daly used to do that at Penn with his big guys. Wouldn't let them dribble. They would carve it in portions.
I remember it all too well.
Mm-hmm.
Bad pass by Leahy. Threw the ball to the wrong side. The defensive man was on that side. But Seton Hall, fortunately, for Pirates fans, it stays at this end.
And Orlando, I just enjoy how he gets after it. I mean, mm-hmm. down on the floor, he goes away with a dirty uniform.
Don't forget, coming up at the conclusion of this game, Olympic Winterfest, Leahy in and out.
And Orlando gets the discard with the hands. The Tavern League shove.
Yep, that's five for Orlando. Antigua did not have a typical game for Antigua. Averages 11 points and five rebounds. He leaves the game having connected on one of six from the floor. Tough outing for Orlando Antigua.
And they never got his personality immersed in the game, and that is a problem for them. They need McCullough's fire and the passion of an Antigua to get them going.
Only a deuce to his credit this afternoon.
Not his numbers. St. Raymond's, Gary Caesar,
mm-hmm.
and Father Charles Cavanaugh, an old friend of ours, is the pastor, runs the school and the cemetery. He's got it all covered. Get you a scholarship, and when you're a little tired, a place to rest.
My goodness, Billy. Sounds like you'd want to stay on his good side, though, you know? If he's got that much responsibility, I want to be on his good side.
Well, his brother, Ed Cavanaugh, went to Fordham.